Up there, Juliet discussed the trouble with being a Capulet. And down here, Romeo did the same about being a Montague. They told each other how much they loved one another. Somebody once decided this was the spot. A million pictures and more later, this little courtyard is a Veronese cash cow. It has long been a tourist attraction. Charles Dickens visited Italy in 1844 and 1845, making his base in Genoa while taking a break from novel writing, between Martin Chuzzlewit and Dombey and Son. During this time, he travelled around the country extensively and collected his thoughts for a travel book, Pictures from Italy. Dickens visits both Verona and Venice and is greatly taken by both. Romeo and Juliet become the focus of his visit to Verona, which he finds so fanciful, quaint and picturesque a place, formed by such a rich variety of fantastic buildings that there could be nothing better at the core of even this romantic town, scene of one of the most romantic and beautiful stories. Yet, when Dickens visits Via Capello, he is not impressed. He writes that the House of the Capulets is now degenerated into a most miserable little inn, with muddy market carts passing by its yard in ankle-deep dirt. He goes on to describe a grim-visaged dog, viciously panting in a doorway, who would certainly have had Romeo by the leg the moment he put it over the wall. Dickens visits the amphitheatre, so well-preserved and carefully maintained that every row of seats is there unbroken, before pounding the streets for hours. I walked through and through the town all the rest of the day and could have walked there until now, I think. Afterwards, he reads Romeo and Juliet in his own room at the inn that night. Of course, no Englishman had ever read it there before. Even back then, people were moving about Europe on tours quite a bit.